Today, I'll explain how atmosphere works so you can make your Roblox game look more realistic. Make sure the Explorer and Properties GUIs are enabled, which you can turn on through the View tab at the top left of your screen. Once you've done this, hover over the lighting and click the plus button to add sky into the workspace. You might already have one, and if you don't like the default one, you can always add a custom one from the toolbox. Once you've done this, we're going to click on the plus button again and add in atmosphere into the lighting. You can customize it by clicking on atmosphere and going down to the properties section. To start, haze creates a sort of foggy mist right above the horizon. So if I bring this back to zero, you'll notice that it starts to go away. And the greater the number, the higher it goes into the atmosphere, and the kind of thicker it becomes. The glare changes how much light comes through the fog. So if I look up over this way, and I raise the glare from 0.45 to a higher number, you'll notice that it starts to become much more blinding. And you start to notice at the edges of some objects that the light is affecting how you see it. I'm gonna lower this back down a little bit just so it's easier to see. And from here we can go up to the density, and this will reduce the distance you can see around you the higher the number goes, because there will be more fog on your screen. In addition to this, the offset value right below it will kind of change the distance from when the fog will start to take an effect. So if I raise this number up higher, you'll notice that it starts to almost lower the intensity of it. So if I change this back down, I'm gonna lower the density around here, and I'm gonna go down to the color setting. The color setting will change the hue of the mist. So if I click on this over here and I start dragging it around, you'll notice that it starts to change. So if you have a higher haze value with some glare in it, you'll notice this effect more, because if I take the haze away, then you don't really see anything different than the normal skybox. You do see some fog over here at the edges, but that's about it. So if I add some haze back, and if we take a look at this last property over here, the decay is the color that you'll see kind of fading away from the sun towards the center. So if I go and change the color over here to a slightly redder color, and then I change the decay over here to somewhat of a blue one, you'll notice that around the sun over here, as it's going away from it, you start to get this redder or pinkish color. And then once you get past that point, it becomes the other color you've set. And this is not very good for me to explain because I'm colorblind, but I think you get the idea. It basically transitions from the decay color around the sun over to the other color you've set. These effects will allow for more realistic ambience in your game, which could work well together with depth of field, which I explained how to use in my previous tutorial, that you can find in the card at the top right of the video or in the description below. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. See y'all later, and have a fantastic rest of your day.